The list of Civil War veterans involved in the creation and settlement of Dakota Territory is long. Most came after the war, but some were already in the region well before the territory was even organized, including John Blair Smith Todd.
John Blair Smith Todd. He is President Lincoln's wife's cousin. And Lincoln and Mary didn't necessarily have a lot of really close family, but Todd was a close family member of theirs. And in fact, he had gotten quite high in rank before the Civil War.
J.B.S. Todd was a West Point graduate who fought in the Second Seminole War in Florida and then in the Mexican-American War. In 1855, he was part of an expedition led by Colonel William S. Harney against the Sioux in Nebraska. Some sources indicate that Todd was involved in the Battle of Blue Water in Nebraska, otherwise known as the Harney Massacre. Todd resigned his commission in 1856 and established himself as a licensed military trader at Fort Randall along the Missouri River. He began to study law. He also entered into a partnership with a fur trader named Daniel Frost, and together they established posts at Bonhomme, Yankton, and Vermilion. In 1858, Todd played a key role in negotiating a treaty with the Yankton Sioux, a treaty that would see most of the Yankton's land handed over to Washington. In return for about 400,000 acres of land and assurances that they would be allowed to live in peace, the Yankton turned over a significant chunk of what is today eastern South Dakota. In 1861, J.B.S. Todd was admitted to the bar and elected to represent Dakota Territory in the U.S. Congress. That same year, he rejoined the U.S. Army as an appointed general of volunteers. His appointment ended in 1862.
He's not really someone who made a name for himself during the Civil War. He stepped in, he helped out, he didn't help out very long. He was only in for about 8 months and had been given the title of Brigadier General of a volunteer regiment from Missouri. And so he served. But his draw was really, you know, the great Dakota Territory, to create Dakota Territory. It was his baby. And he really wanted to be the first governor of the Dakota Territory.
J.B.S. Todd's story would have been remarkable even without what he experienced in Washington, D.C. on the evening of April 14, 1865. A cane that once belonged to Todd and now belongs to a Yankton museum was with him on that fateful night.
The artifact that we have at the Mead Cultural Education Center is a cane that was given to J.B.S. Todd 1 month before Ford's Theater and Abraham Lincoln's assassination. And he was in Ford's Theater the night of the assassination, next door. And in fact, there's a long, drawn-out account of his being there for Mary, consoling her, being in the room several times, in and out, and things like that. So he had that cane with him the night of the assassination of Abraham Lincoln.
J.B.S. Todd returned to Dakota and remained active in politics and business. He died in 1872 and is buried in the Yankton Cemetery.